Hi, hello, namaste. A very warm welcome to Bio Classes. We are in a very interesting chapter, that is the biotechnology principle and process chapter. And already we observed up to cloning vectors, right? We observed actually what actually that biotechnology is. I'm brushing up the things already that had been covered. Why? Because I think 10-12 days gap over because of some other different activities. I'm brushing up the things that have been already covered in this chapter. So what we observed, what actually the biotechnology is, the meaning of biotechnology we understood. And next we observed that the principles of biotechnology, genetic engineering and biochemical engineering, we observed too. And that genetic engineering also we called it as rDNA technology, right? That means recombinant DNA technology. Then we observed the tools for construction of rDNA. That means, what are the different materials we need for developing or constructing one rDNA? So, six tools we observed. Restriction enzymes, DNA ligase, DNA polymerase, cloning vector, host cell, and bioreactor. Right? Like that, we observed six tools majorly. There, we observed one thing. So, before going to that actual concept, let me clear the things. Here, the whole biotechnology means we are using the organisms according to our wish, according to our need, according to our desire. We are using different organisms. We may use plants, we may use animals, we may use microorganisms according to our wish. That means to get any product, biological product, or to get any service, we are using microorganisms or we are using plants or animals. While using, we are changing organisms. How? Changing their DNA. By changing the DNA of organism, we are changing the total organism according to our wish to get any one particular product. So that is how we are getting the biotechnology usage. Right? To construct that rDNA, we observed six major tools. The first tool is restriction enzyme. They're important, restriction endonuclease enzyme. For what? For cutting a DNA at particular place. Then we observed a DNA ligase enzyme, that is a joining enzyme. That means different DNAs can be joined by the DNA ligase, right? And next one we observed DNA polymerase enzyme. So that enzyme helps in doubling of DNA. Here a doubling of rDNA. And next one we observed host cell. Host cell means the cell which will receive that rDNA. So usually that is a bacterial cell. And the next one, cloning vector. Cloning vector means the plasmid, majorly here we are using double-stranded, circular, autonomously replicating DNA, special DNA, that is plasmid. And already once we have observed one plasmid, PBR322. So that plasmid, that is a cloning vector. And next one, we are having a bioreactor. So after construction of rDNA, how we are constructing rDNA? We are taking one plasmid, we are going to cut the plasmid, and into that plasmid we are adding our desired gene, our selected gene we are adding. We will get rDNA. That rDNA introduced into one host cell, then the cell becomes recombinant. Otherwise that is not recombinant. And these recombinant cells are grown in one big vessel. So that vessel is bioreactor. So after growing the cells in bioreactor, we are getting the gene product. So this is how the sequence is going on. But already we have completed the major concept, cloning vector, PBR322 related concept. So one heltini, nemge ee chapter innu connect aagbeku antandre previous 2-3 video galu nodkondu idu nodkondre nimge easy aagi connect aagta hogutte, right? So already we have completed a cloning vector portion. Now let us focus on the next very interesting concept, that is competent host cell. The next concept is competent host cell for what? For transformation of rDNA. A transformation of what? rDNA. So before going to that, let me clarify here. let me clarify you. This is the plasmid, right? Circular autonomously replicated double stranded DNA. This plasmid mixed with our desired gene. How we are mixing here? By cutting this plasmid at one place. Who will cut that plasmid? Restriction endonuclease enzyme, right? Then both the DNAs are joined. Who will join? DNA ligase. After joining, we are going to get this kind of structure, right? And this is rDNA. Now the DNA is recombined, rDNA. Now this is our desired gene. From this gene, we are getting one product. This gene should be introduced into the bacteria, but we can't insert the gene alone. It is mixed with the plasmid. This plasmid is cloning vector. Cloning vector plus the desired gene, we are going to get rDNA. Now rDNA is prepared. Now this rDNA introduced into one host cell, suitable host cell. But here is a problem. Problem is that rDNA on its own simply cannot enter inside the host cell. It is a difficult process. So to receive that rDNA from the host cell, we need to make the host cell competent. So next concept is competent of host cell. Competent and the meaning enandre rDNA na receive madkolike host cell na ready madodanta. That means host cell must get the ability to receive that rDNA, to receive this rDNA. We need to make the host cell competent. So that one only I have written here for transformation of rDNA. Transformation means the transferring of DNA from one source to another source. So here another source means cell. So from outer source to DNA enters inside the bacterial cell. That process is transformation. Already we observed the transformation principle in the Griffith experiment. Transferring of DNA from R strain to S, or from S strain to R strain, right? Transformation means transferring of DNA. Which DNA? rDNA. Into what? Host cell. But host cell cannot receive the rDNA simply. We need to prepare the host cell to receive the rDNA. That process is competent the host cell for transforming rDNA. Why that problem will be arise? See here. If we consider the simply DNA, right? So DNA, this molecule is hydrophilic molecule. The very first thing, what this DNA is? Hydrophilic molecule. We know two kinds of molecules, hydrophilic and hydrophobic. Hydro here, it stands for water. Philic means loving or attracting, attracting for water. That means hydrophilic molecules are dissolved in water. Another term is there, hydrophobic. Those molecules are not dissolved in water, hydrophobic. But here DNA is a hydrophilic molecule. Now the next thing is, we are having the bacterial cell here, right? So this is the bacterial cell we are having, and this is the rDNA. rDNA should enter inside the bacterial cell. So we will consider that a bacterial cell as host cell. After entering rDNA inside the host cell, then the host cell becomes recombinant cell. But here it is having the cell wall upper side here. Battery is having cell wall. After breaking the cell wall, next it is having the plasma membrane. What is this layer? Plasma membrane. That plasma membrane is hydrophobic. Yes, plasma membrane is hydrophobic. Are you getting? Plasma membrane is hydrophobic, DNA is hydrophilic. That means both the natures are different. Why plasma membrane is hydrophobic means plasma membrane is made up of lipids, phospholipid bilayer. It is made up of lipid. Lipid is hydrophobic. That means both the natures are different. Hence, hydrophilic DNA cannot cross the hydrophobic plasma membrane. Hydrophilic DNA, which DNA? rDNA. Hydrophilic rDNA cannot enter the hydrophobic plasma membrane. That means cell cannot receive rDNA. Hence, we have to prepare the host cell to receive that rDNA. We have to change that cell. So that process is making the host cell competent for receiving rDNA. So here we are having some procedures for competing the host cell, for making the cell competent for receiving rDNA. So the first process is heat shock method. The first principle is first method, heat shock method. So what actually we are doing is that same cell, same bacterial cell, already it is having the DNA inside. Now rDNA should be entered, right? Now these bacterial cells are treated with calcium ions. That means bivalent ions. Majorly we are considering calcium ions. That means we are making one solution. That solution is having bivalent ions, majorly calcium ions. In that solution, these cells are treated. We are mixing the cells and we are treating the cells. And after that, the cells are subjected for ice incubation. Next step, the cells are subjected to ice incubation. That means after treating the host cells in a calcium bi-ions, that means a bivalent ions, the cells are incubated in ice. Incubation antandre a place nalli idodu anta artha. So incubated in ice means we are keeping those cells in the refrigerated condition, like. And suddenly the cells are next subjected for heat shock. What is the next step? Suddenly cells are given with heat. That heat is about 62 degrees Celsius. Now to the cells we are giving 62 degrees Celsius heat. That means here, ice condition is suddenly converted into 62 degrees Celsius heat shock condition. When suddenly condition changed, then holes are created on the bacterial plasma membrane. So here holes are created, right? Holes are created. That means bacterial cell membrane becomes porous. Through the holes, through the pores, the rDNA enter inside. Then again, after the heat shock, ice incubation is given. Once again, cells are kept in ice condition. That means alternate, ice, heat, ice, alternate conditions. Because of that reason, so pores are created, rDNA entered inside, and pores are closed. Now the cell becomes recombinant, right? And this method is heat shock method, first one. And a very interesting second method we are having, micro injection. What is the second method? Micro injection, very interesting one. We know already injection. Micro injection means it is the injection which is used to inject rDNA into animal cell, not a bacterial cell, animal cell. Say for example, if you are having the animal cell here, right? So this is the nucleus and this is the DNA of animal cell. Now by using one injection, directly rDNA is injected into nucleus of animal cell. But that is not the normal injection. That is a very, very minute micro injection. That micro injection is having rDNA, this kind of rDNA, and injected into this animal cell nucleus. So this is micro injection. And it is used for animal cell, to introduce rDNA into animal cell. So this is second method. And we are having a third method. So that is gene gun method. What is the next one? Gene gun method. So this is also very interesting one. Gene gun we are using. Gene gun, right? We know already gun. So gun is loaded with bullets. After triggering the gun, the bullets will be reach the target point, right? But here the gun is loaded with genes. Which genes? Here gene means rDNA. It's a very interesting one. See here. In this method, they are using gold or tungsten particles. What we are using? Gold or tungsten particles. These are the nanoparticles we are using, right? Very, very minute nanoparticles. We can't see those particles. Nano, 10 to the power minus 9. Already we know that size. Such kind of very small nanoparticles made up of gold and tungsten. Those are acting as bullets. So, for example, if this is the nanoparticle means, if it is the bullet means, this bullet is wrapped with rDNA. It is wrapped with suttodadke. It is wrapped with rDNA. And those bullets are loaded in one gun. What is that gun? Gene gun. And this gene gun is triggered towards the plant cell. Then it is triggered towards the plant cell. Yes. It is triggered towards the plant cell. Then rDNA enters into plant cell. So this method we will call it as gene gun method. Right? Gene gun method, it is used for plant cell, and the bullets used are gold and tungsten, and micro injections are used for animal cell. If the host cell is animal cell, then a heat shock method, it is used for bacterial cells. For one kind of host cells, we are using different kinds of competent methods, and also we can use disarmed pathogens also. Use of disarmed pathogens. Already we know pathogens. This is causing organisms, right? And these pathogens, let us consider virus. Virus are the pathogens, right? These viruses are used for delivering of our DNA. For delivering of our DNA, we are using virus pathogens. But what kind of virus pathogens? Disarmed. Disarmed means those viruses are not harmful. Of course, those are virus, not harmful. Why? Because in that virus, disease causing or dangerous genes are removed and our genes are added. Are you getting? In the virus, of course, if it is having the DNA, means that DNA is having so many genes, and some genes are very dangerous to our body. Those genes we are going to cut and remove. Our genes are added there. Such kind of disarmed pathogen is used for delivering of our desired gene. So such kind of pathogens, usually we are using retroviruses. Right? We are using retroviruses. So all of these are the different kinds of methods for making a host cell competent for transferring of our rDNA. Into which cell? Host cell, right? So these are the different kinds of methods we are having. Okay. Now, inside the host cell, we introduce that rDNA. So till now, we observed the tools of rDNA technology. How to construct rDNA, we observed. We observed different kinds of materials. But still, we have not seen the process of rDNA construction. That means a genetic engineering process. How actually the process is done? Process of genetic engineering. So are you getting this total one? Right? How to make the host cell competent, right? How to make the host cell competent? Competent means to receive the rDNA, which is formed, to receive that rDNA, we are making the host cell competent. And the host cell rDNA ready. To make the host cell competent, we are using these methods. Heat shock method, microinjection method, gene gun method, and a disarmed pathogens method. We are using different kinds of methods. So till now, what we observed? We observed the major tools of rDNA technology. One cutting enzyme, one joining enzyme, one DNA doubling enzyme, and a cloning vector plasmid we observed PBR322. Next one you observed host cell. Host cell means usually bacterial cell. Next one is bioreactor. We can observe the bioreactor in later stages. So till now we observed only the tools, how to use the tools for construction of rDNA. But from this class onwards, from the next class onwards, let us focus on the process of genetic engineering. How the steps are occurring in a genetic engineering while constructing rDNA. Steps. So let us see those concepts in our next class. Right?